Could you imagine a world where you could smell the numbers while you do your banking? Taste the letters in a recipe while you cook your favorite dish? Or perhaps see waves of color emitting out of the speakers right now as you hear my voice? Would this be a beautiful experience? Or do you think it might become a little overwhelming? Well, for some, such an experience is their reality. This is Dynamic Science. Who needs LSD when today we're going to be exploring the multisensory phenomenon that is synesthesia? Synesthesia is a neurological condition in which information that is meant to only stimulate one cognitive pathway, such as sound on your eardrums, instead activates several of your senses, such as hearing, seeing, and tasting sound all at once. In contrast to anesthesia, which means no sensation, the word synesthesia implies joint sensation. Our five senses, hearing, sight, taste, touch, and smell, merge in various ways to create a completely new perspective of the world around you. There are many types of synesthesia, each with varying symptoms, such as grapheme color synesthesia, considered one of the most common. An individual will involuntarily experience the perception of color with numbers and letters. Chromesthesia, or sound to color synesthesia, is, you guessed it, the perception of colors with sound. Lexical gestatory synesthesia, spoken and written words having distinct tastes, smells, and textures. And the list goes on, with some rarer and more intriguing than others, such as auditory tactile synesthesia, when sounds produce tactile sensations inside or outside of the body. So, what exactly is going on here? Why do some humans experience such a mixture of sensations, without a little helping hand, if you know what I mean? And the answer, of course, the nervous system. Each one of your five senses is associated with a specific area of your brain. Say you're hooked up to an fMRI machine and you're looking at a bright neon yellow wall. Well, the primary visual cortex at the back of your brain will light up. However, if you're a synesthete, you may also be able to taste the neon wall. So the primary gestatory cortex located towards the front of the brain will also light up at the same time, which is why researchers assert that people who have synesthesia have a high level of interconnectedness between the parts of the brain that are tied to sensory stimulus. Synesthesia cannot be categorized as a disability or disorder, rather a rare and unique trait, and for some, even a gift, such as grapheme color synesthesia aiding memory. But could you imagine the other end of the spectrum? Your favorite ice cream smelling like durian? Or the experience of negative and aggressive emotions to sound, which is what those with the rarest type of synesthesia experience, misophonia? Researchers are not completely sure how common this condition is, but a 2006 study by the University of Sussex approximated that about 2 to 4% of the human population are synesthetes. And you are more likely to have the condition if you are left-handed or a woman. If you are one of the few that do have such a diverse sensory experience, it is still very possible to live a full and successful life, just like Kanye West, Vladimir Nabokov, Billy Joel, Lorde, and Pharrell Williams. Could you imagine an extra dimension on top of your experience of the world? It's a good thing then that those without synesthesia can temporarily access such a universe through the help of certain psychedelic compounds like LSD and psilocybins. Not that we would ever promote such a thing, strictly a thought experiment. Enjoying the content? Then shout us a coffee. And don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to our channel for your weekly dose of dynamic science.